Best way to start my Guild Wars 2 YouTube content is with the first impressions video. I know it comes 4 years too late, but I just started playing the game in the middle of last month, December. It's almost the middle of January today, and that means I have a little bit under a month of total playtime. I thought it's cool to share with you guys my impressions. Coming after 6 years of Aeon, you can imagine that Guild Wars 2 for me is a brand new experience. I'm gonna try to be brief because the game has been out for a few years, and if I would get into every single detail, then I could probably talk for a few hours. We're gonna focus on the things that were important to me to find in the game, the things that I did, and the things that I was looking for, yeah? Coming from 6 years of Aeon, it is impossible not to compare Guild Wars with Aeon and not to look for certain things that maybe you used to have in Aeon. Or whatnot. So I did the same, and yeah, that's probably how it's always gonna be for me. Played Aeon too long to forget it, yeah? Cool, so first things first, this game extremely convenient and user-friendly. I can appreciate that to God and back, because everything in the game is about convenience. It's about user-friendliness, and I appreciate that a lot. The cash shop is based on convenience items and skins. Everything from the trade broker, you can access it from wherever you are. You can sell stuff, you can buy stuff, whatever you need to do, you can do it from wherever you are. You don't necessarily need to be there. Crafting is extremely easy to learn. All the panels, the PvP panel is, you know, a click away. The worldview world panel is a click away. The guild panel is a click away. The mailbox is a click away. You know, everything is super, super convenient. That's one thing that I appreciate the most. The second thing that I want to talk about is the PvP system, because I think it's just fantastic. The 5v5 especially, I didn't do any worldview world PvP because I'm not really yet at that stage. I wasn't really that interested in it, but I did a lot of 5v5, or at least it seemed like a lot. In my 1 month of playing the game, I got over 600 games. Most of them obviously unranked, because I just played all the classes basically. I really wanted to get all the classes to level 80 to try them in PvE, and I really wanted to play at least 50 or 100 games on each class so I can actually get a good feel on it in PvP. I've played some ranked PvP as well. I can say that PvP is super cool because it's fair, it's very much skill based and knowledge based, and it's just awesome to do. However, I do feel that the ranked PvP has a couple of flaws. First of all, I understand why they limited the queue to 2-man, but then again, if they did that, I would have liked to see another button here for team queues, where groups of 5 queue up versus groups of 5, or 3-man party with a 2-man party, find another 3-man party and a 2-man party, or another 5-man, because it's pretty unfair for people that actually want to do what this button says, which is compete. I'm a very competitive guy, and if I try to play something that is meta, and if I try to play a meta thief with a dagger pistol and just go decap cap and decap and plus one, then that really doesn't happen in silver, bronze, and a little bit of gold that I have personally experienced. So it's a little bit weird to go to, you know, websites meta battle and get a meta mesmer build, and to watch the pro players play mesmer and thief, and you want to also do the same things, and you're trying really hard to be aware and map and plussing and stealing, you know, mowing and stuff, and then at the end of the day the team doesn't really help you in any way. It's a really awkward feeling, a feeling of helplessness when you play meta mesmer in silver division. It's just completely pointless. It doesn't help at all, and you feel more useless than anyone else, because you're just the playmaker type that needs to plus one, but there's nobody to plus one. Anyway, the point is, I understand, and there is no perfect system. There has to be some flaws, but the ranked system is a little bit weird, and yeah, those meta builds don't really work, at least in the lower end divisions. That's what I found in my month of playing. So it's really hard to practice on a meta build in low divisions like I want to practice, because there's nobody to practice with, because there's some classes that actually require team input or team to do this thing now with you. In any case, that's the thing that I did. I really loved it. I didn't get into World v World, but I am going to. Yeah, cool. So I guess that's it about PvP. PvP is really rewarding. PvP is awesome to do because you can get PvE gear by doing PvP. You can get stuff like these Tomes of Knowledge, which gives you basically one level if you're under 80 and one something else if you're 80 yourself. Then you can give them to your alts. Basically, I can get an alt from 0 to 38, you know, just by using these right now. That's really awesome. You get lots of dice from the ranked arena. Ah, one more thing about ranked arena. The button says compete, but then again, I do understand that all the community needs to participate and, you know, wants to play ranked arena to get the rewards. However, I did feel very much annoyed with very many people that just played ranked and they just said at the beginning of the match or when you confronted them, why did they do this and why didn't they do that? They said they're just there for the peeps. They don't care about winning or losing. They are just there to get their rewards because they also want those rewards, and that's really fair, you know, because everyone wants rewards, right? But I'm just saying it's kind of annoying for competitive players, or, you know, for players that really, you know, want to do the... Don't get me wrong, I'm not a pro player. I'm just saying that people that want to do stuff right, like myself, get a little bit annoyed when there's people that are just there for the peeps and they just don't care how they play. I've seen everything in bronze and silver and a bit of gold, from, I don't know, mesmers with 5 signets to pistol thieves and really weird stuff going on, which doesn't really allow you as an opponent to grow. And it's ranked, it's not unranked. In unranked, I understand, do whatever you want. In any case, PvE, I haven't done much PvE, I promise I will, but I haven't done much. This game is very sidetracky, that's another thing I can say. When you start doing something, when you want to quest your level 40, ooh, there's a heart, ooh, there's an event, whoa, there's that happening, whoa, there's this, wait, personal story, let's queue up for a PvP game, let's do a dungeon, no, wait, there's something to gather. Everything is so rewarding and it's so sidetracked. It takes you to 6 different roads and it is a nice feeling, don't get me wrong, but it's very weird, at least for me. So I haven't got the chance to do a lot of PvE because I've done a lot of PvP and basically I've just spent all my time doing PvP because it was really important to me. I've done some dungeons, I've done a couple of beginner fractals, which is the end game version of Guild Wars 2 dungeons. Didn't do any raids. I'm really looking forward to experience those. By the way, speaking of PvE and stuff, thank you so much for all of you that actually for some reason were subscribed to my channel and you know, contacted me in game. We played together, so thank you for the fun, thank you for the runs, because some of you actually insisted on me joining you in Guild Wars 2 for some runs. So yeah, thanks for that. Other than that, what else can I say about the game? It is very comfortable to get end game gear in terms of PvE. There is a grind. If you really want to grind, there is a grind. I've heard people saying that, oh, there's nothing to do, game is boring. No, game is not boring at all. Every game has its own grind. In every game, at one point you reach a point in which there's nothing for you left to do besides the same things that you've just done for the past 6 months. So nothing wrong with that. It's just that some games have this to do, some games have another thing to do. Some games you need to deposit thousands of euros and some games you don't. You just need to, you know, farm fractals and raids until next content comes so you can be ready. So it's various things that you can do, and at the end of the day, MMOs are all the same. Grind and grind. It's the same in Guild Wars. There is grind, but it's a lot more fun because it's action combat and, you know, it's just how it is. It's cool. In terms of classes, guys, since I told you that I'm gonna play a Rev, I'm not gonna play a Rev because this game destroyed everything I knew about MMORPGs and classes and specs, and I don't know, guys, I'm not sure what I'm gonna play. I'm still trying out stuff. I'm still trying out. I was trying out Necro in PvP these days. I want to try that one out. I still have a couple of other plans to try out, but I'm not quite sure. This game has taken me to places I never thought I'm gonna be at. So I am in a situation in which I'm super confused and yeah. In any case, I'm gonna update you in another video of what I'm gonna do. Other than that, what else? The community is extremely freaking talkative. I mean, I've done an event called Triple Double. Triple. No, no, wait, that's basket. That's basketball stuff. Triple Trouble. So there's like three worms that you need to kill. People say, oh my god, it's so hard. Guys, it's not hard. If you've played Wildstar and if you've done good there, Guild Wars 2 PvE is not hard. Anyway, people here sure love to talk. People here are awesome. And speaking of people, one other thing that I've noticed about the game, PvE and PvP players are kind of completely separated. For some particular reason in this game, I have noticed that the people that do a lot of really good PvE, you know, really quality PvE, they don't really do quality PvP. And the people that do quality PvP, they don't really PvE at all. It's very weird to me, and I'm still looking forward to putting my finger on that. But anyway, it's just how it is for some reason. So streamers do the same. I've been watching quite a lot of streams, so I can see what the general mentality is for people, what's the community like. The events, Triple Trouble. Events are awesome. The community is awesome. The community is really helpful, very talkative. I mean, during that Triple fucking Trouble event, holy shit, did they talk on TeamSpeak non-stop for an hour and a half. I don't even know how you can talk so much. They have a lot of good websites that would help you. They have DPS meter, very important, very big no-no Guild Wars 2. There is no legitimate DPS meter, which is a very big no-no. I mean, I'm a competitive player and I need to have a DPS meter in order to actually see how well I'm doing in compared to my guildies, compared to my good friends, etc. And I really want to see how well I'm doing compared to other good people that currently play the game. So not having a legitimate DPS meter, there is one really good one, but supposedly it's a hack and it's not allowed. This is a very big no-no. In every competitive MMORPG that's all about numbers, dodging and doing good DPS, especially one, a clusterfuck like Guild Wars that you don't really understand what's going on, when you're clumped up on a boss, then a DPS meter would be super, super helpful, a legal one. Yeah, that would be super helpful. Mouse kind of gets lost in the decor, that I have to figure out. Maybe you guys that are playing Guild Wars 2 can help me with my mouse. And that's about it. These are my first impressions. I think it's an awesome game. I feel great in the game. I hope I'm going to be here for a very long time. And yeah, I'm still in testing period in regards to my class, in regards to builds, in regards to everything. I'm going to show you guys, probably my next video is going to be some PvP footage that I accumulated in the past 3 weeks. Because I wasn't doing PvP from the beginning, I was leveling up as well. And yeah, I'm gonna update you when I know something for sure also. Very confusing game, it destroys, it broke my balls basically. I don't know what life is anymore. I'm really curious to know what is your opinion about the ranked PvP, because this is actually a concern for me. What is your opinion in terms of people queuing up just for peeps? People not really giving a... Wow, you can climb here. Very. See, look what a game this is. This is a very sidetracked game. I can't even make a YouTube video without getting sidetracked to climb on a thing. And then obviously, from here, I'm gonna wanna look around and then I'm gonna wanna glide somewhere. Tell me, guys that are playing Guild Wars, tell me what do you think about the PvP system, the ranked one? What do you think about giving an option to queue as a team? just so I can play with my friends and at least blame them if they fail, or at least I can make a portal play on my mesmer, or at least I can make a plus one on my thief because there's someone to plus one. Tell me what you think, and also tell me what you are doing at end game. I'm always very curious. Whenever I go join a new game, I'm very curious about all sorts of nonsense and bullshit. Whatever people are doing, I'm curious because the more you know, the better you can form your own opinion about what you wanna personally do. There's no need to disregard something just because it's noobish or it's stupid or it doesn't give you this and that. So tell me in the comments below. Other than that, guys, don't forget to subscribe and lots of love. See you soon.